dude, the banquet is in 2 hours and we don't even have a video. What are we gonna do? We are so fucked right now.
I know, man. The grade 12 class is gonna kill us. They're expecting a really awesome video by now.
Dude, stop eating. We got a video to prepare and we only have like 2 hours to do it. I got it! Us eating. It's such a great and simple video idea and we can make it in like 2 hours.
Alright, Nicholas Tang, thank you for coming to your IB interview.
Yeah.
Now that I've finished asking any questions I had for you, is there any questions you have for me?
Yeah. So you're the IB coordinator around here. Is that fair to say?
Absolutely. I'm Mr. Boissy.
So what do you do around here as a coordinator, Mr. Boissy?
Well, the first thing I do is...
Wake up!
Like a boss!
Shake my head!
Like a boss!
Brush my teeth!
Like a boss!
Eat a burger!
Like a boss!
Oh, fuck! Shit it out!
Like a boss!
Teach your math class!
Like a boss!
Drive a function!
Like a boss!
Integrate it!
Like a boss!
All I did!
Like a boss!
Add a C!
Like a boss!
Analyze!
Like a boss!
Synthesize!
Like a boss!
Approve cast!
Like a boss!
Gross grind!
Like a boss!
Twice an hour!
Like a boss!
My own office!
Like a boss!
Mark some tests!
Like a boss!
Post some marks!
Like a boss!
Get mobbed!
Like a boss!
Swallow sadness!
Like a boss!
Get inked!
Like a boss!
No regrets!
Like a boss!
Take out the trash!
Like a boss!
Get arrested!
Like a boss!
Break out of jail!
Like a boss!
Go streaking!
Like a boss!
Rearrested!
Like a boss!
Life sentence!
Like a boss!
Wax my leg!
Like a boss!
Get abducted!
Like a boss!
Crash into a tree!
Like a boss!
And then retire!
Like a boss!
Dear Venture 10 me.
Dear Venture 10 me. Roller coasters are fun. Don't be that kid who stands there watching your friends ride the elevator. You'll never hear the end of it.
The internet isn't just for YouTube or games. Read the online news one every once in a while.
Dear Venture 10 me. Keep a daily journal and take more pictures because you have the worst memory ever.
Sleeping in the IB office is completely acceptable if you have a pillow and a blanket and there's people around you that don't draw on you.
The winning lottery ticket numbers are 15, 22, 34, 38, 41, and...
Best way to release stress? Go cliff diving. It's freaking exhilarating.
Make sure you start charging people to come to your house.
Stay away from Starbucks or you'll be bankrupt.
Add on to your connections like going to a completely different school in your grad year.
If you invested a dollar every time you stayed up late watching Asian dramas, I would be very rich right now.
Make sure you eat your breakfast. It helps with your growth.
Start picking out at McDonald's now because you don't start gaining the pounds in your thighs until you hit grade 11.
But most of all...
And most of all,
make sure you never...
NEVER!
Ever!
Make sure you never take IB.
Dear Venture 10 me,
make sure you never listen to Zach.
Because 10 years from now,
10 years from now,
you're not going to remember that e to the I pi equals negative 1.
Or that the fall of the chain was due to political,
social, and economic descent.
You're not going to remember all those times you stayed up all night studying for those exams.
You're not going to remember all 4,000 words of your extended essay.
And you sure as hell aren't going to go through life thinking, how do I know this to be true?
No, you're not going to remember any of this stuff. The stuff that made IB such an ordeal.
No, you aren't. Instead, you're going to remember all of the awesome times and moments that IB provided you with.
Like that time you saw Vivian Tang tipping over the desk in French class.
You're going to remember that awesome summer when we just hung out and went to places in BC we'd never been to before, like Wycliffe Park and Lynn Valley.
That outrageous moment where Mr. Fitz took out his painted toenails in front of the whole class.
The time you made a fool out of yourself on stage in front of the whole school.
When you went to Loon Lake and you made a bunch of new friends.
It's watching Kara run full speed into a mirror at the art gallery.
Running for school president. It was one of the scariest things I've ever done, but my friends helped me get through it.
The epic time that we made a chicken nugget, double chicken pizza sandwich.
Discovering the awesomeness that is the Prop House / Oso Negro / Sex Panther Cafe, and yet never getting addicted to caffeine.
The time that we downed 144 weights.
How instead of learning math, you decided to learn how to do the Soulja Boy dance with your friends.
Taking part in the legendary tradition of procrastinating with friends.
Those times you scared Megan.
Megan!
The day I punched Vanessa in the face and he cried.
You're going to remember how you spent whole nights playing Red Alert 3 with your buddies.
That time at camp with Nick and Moses are like, eat, drink, and sweep like a venture!
All those times we shot hoops at the rec center.
Staying up all night just to be able to eat at Denny's at 5 in the morning.
All those times we just spent at Grandview McDonald's just chilling.
The time that Michelle, Farrell, and I all wrote a song for AJ to ask AJ out to prom.
That time me and Leah ambushed Megan at her house, made pancakes, and then fell asleep on her couch.
When Mr. Willen was referring to waves refracting as waves that were kinking. So in physics class, we were talking about kinky waves.
Those awesome birthday parties that we had.
Eating 10 bags of fries because the IB boys went to every single McDonald's during the Monopoly promotion.
That time you got freaked out by Miss Brown's dead goldfish.
That time you fell in love.
You're gonna remember that how in the span of 2 years, your family grew from 5 to 30.
If it weren't for Ivy, there wouldn't be tears in my eyes from having to leave these amazing individuals.
So dear Venture 10 me.
Dear Venture 10 me.
Dear Venture 10 me.
Dear Venture 10 me.
When you make that decision to go into IB,
make sure you say yes.
Say yes.
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 Because if it wasn't for IB,
I wouldn't be the person I am today.
It started out as a feeling, which then grew into a hope, which then turned into a quiet thought, which then turned into a quiet word. And then that word grew louder and louder, till it was a battle cry. When you call me, no need to say goodbye. Just because everything's changing doesn't mean it's never been this way before. All you can do is try to know who your friends are as you head off to the war. Pick a star on the dark horizon and follow the light. You'll come back when it's over. No need to say goodbye. You'll come back when it's over. No need to say goodbye. Thank you. Now we're back to the beginning. It's just a feeling and no one knows yet. But just because they can't feel it too doesn't mean that you have to forget. Let your memories grow stronger and stronger till they're before your eyes.